We will now discuss the solution of a problem from the section Linear Algebra. The problem is on matrices, and this problem has appeared in CSIR National Eligibility Test held on 30th November 2020, and it is from the section B. The problem is, let us define a matrix A belongs to M n suffix n over R to be positive if for every column vector V belongs to R power n, we have the inner product AV comma V greater than or equal to 0, where this inner product is the standard inner product of R power n. Let A alpha beta be the 3 by 3 matrix whose first row is alpha 1 1, second row 1 0 0, third row 1 0 beta. Let S be the set of all those ordered pairs alpha comma beta belongs to R square, where A alpha beta is positive. Which of the following statement is true? The four options are given to us. The first option is S is empty. The second option is alpha beta, the ordered pair, belongs to S if and only if the product alpha beta greater than 0. And the third option, ordered pair alpha beta belongs to S if and only if alpha plus beta plus 4 is greater than 0. And the option 4 is S is the whole of R square. Let's now discuss the solution of this problem. We have the following definition given in the question. That is, a matrix A belongs to the set of all n by n matrices whose entries are coming from the real field. A belongs to M and R to be positive if the inner product AV comma V greater than or equal to 0 for every column vector V belongs to R power n, where this inner product is the standard inner product that is there in R power n. We have the given matrix A alpha beta, and S is the set of all those ordered pairs alpha comma beta belongs to R square, such that A alpha beta is positive. Required to find the elements of S. So what is S? That is the question. And we have that 3 by 3 matrix A alpha beta. You observe that it is a symmetric matrix. Now let V is equal to the column vector V1, V2, V3 be any element of R cube. Then the inner product A alpha beta V comma V is the inner product of the matrix A into V comma V. And when you multiply A with V, you will get alpha V1 plus V2 plus V3. This is the element. And V1, and when you multiply third row in the column, you'll get V1 plus beta V3, comma V1, V2, V3. So these are the elements from R cube. And the inner product is the standard inner product, that is alpha V1 plus V2 plus V3 multiplied by V1 plus V1 multiplied by V2 plus V1 plus beta V3 multiplied by V3. So that is the outcome, and multiply and group them suitably, then you will get alpha V1 square plus 2 times V1 V2 plus 2 times V1 V3 plus beta V3 square. If you observe this, this is a quadratic form in 3 variables V1, V2, V3, and we will write this as V transpose alpha 1 1 1 0 0 1 0 beta V. V transpose A alpha beta V. This is the matrix representation of this quadratic form. And A alpha beta is the matrix of the quadratic form. Continue in the next slide. We have S is equal to the set of all ordered pairs alpha beta belongs to R square, such that A alpha beta is positive. That is, all those ordered pairs alpha beta belongs to R square, such that the inner product A alpha beta multiplied by V comma V greater than or equal to 0 for all V belongs to R cube. That is the definition of the positiveness. And the set of all those ordered pairs alpha comma beta belongs to R square, and the inner product of A alpha beta V comma V greater than or equal to 0 is the V transpose A alpha beta V greater than or equal to 0 for all V belongs to R cube. That is, the set of all those alpha beta belongs to R square, where this quadratic form V transpose A alpha beta V is positive semi-definite. Why? This is greater than or equal to 0 for all V belongs to R cube, then the quadratic form is said to be positive semi-definite. And we now recall the following result. For an n by n symmetric matrix A, the following two are equivalent. The first one is the quadratic form V transpose AV greater than or equal to 0 for all V belongs to R power n. And the second one is all the principal minors of that matrix A are non-negative. These are the two equivalents. So V transpose AV greater than or equal to 0 for all V belongs to R power n means it is positive semi-definite. Then this is equivalent to all the principal minors of A are non-negative. Let's continue. So that's our yes. And how to say that this matrix is semi-positive definite? So condition we have, the all its principal minors of A alpha beta are greater than or equal to 0. The principal minors of order 1 are alpha, 0, beta. Principal minors of order 2, alpha, 1, 1, 0. That is the determinant, that is minus 1. The other one is alpha, 1, 1, beta. Alpha 1, 1 beta, the determinant is alpha beta minus 1. And the other one is 0, 0 beta, the determinant of that is 0. And we are now considering the principal minors, not the leading principal minors. There is a difference. Now the principal minor of order 3, the determinant of the whole of the matrix and expand it by the second row, it's very easy, then you get the answer is minus beta. And all the principal minors of A alpha beta are non-negative, means alpha greater than 0, beta greater than 0, minus 1 greater than 0, greater than or equal to 0, alpha beta minus 1 greater than or equal to 0, minus beta greater than or equal to 0. Now beta greater than or equal to 0, minus beta greater than or equal to 0 will imply beta is equal to 0. And that will imply alpha greater than or equal to 0, beta is equal to 0, and minus 1 greater than or equal to 0. Minus 1 greater than or equal to 0. Now let's look at our S. So the set of all those alpha beta belongs to R square, such that V transpose A alpha beta V is positive semi-definite. That means all the principal minors of A alpha beta are non-negative. That means the set of all those alpha beta belongs to R square, where alpha greater than or equal to 0, minus 1 greater than or equal to 0, beta is equal to 0. And notice that in this, minus 1 greater than or equal to 0 is an untenable condition. So that is, now S is empty. Why? Because it involves an untenable condition, minus 1 greater than or equal to 0. So thus, S is empty is our answer. And our answer is option 1 is true, that is S is empty. So that is the discussion of the solution of the problem from the section Linear Algebra. And the question is based on the definiteness, that is it a semi-positive definiteness of a given matrix. I hope that you have understood the solution of this problem, and it is an interesting problem based on the definitions and some results on the semi-positive definiteness. And I am sure that you have understood all these things and work out some more problems on quadratic forms and matrices. I wish you all the best. Thank you.